Hello friends, I'm Sudhir and you're enjoying the YouTube channel English Carnival, a journey of learning with joy. Friends, today we are going to explore John Masefield's most popular composition called Laugh and Be Merry. But friends, before we proceed, as usual, I request you to subscribe the channel by just pressing the subscribe button and hitting the bell icon so that you may get the notifications of uploaded such academic videos on this particular channel called English Carnival in coming days. Friends, before we proceed, let us see some basic objectives of our today's video, and we have to understand John Masefield's literary contribution in brief. Number two, we have to explore, study and understand John Masefield's popular composition Laugh and Be Merry. Number three, we have to understand the meanings of different words used in this particular composition by John Masefield. And number four, we have to summarize the poem conveniently with simple words and explain it easily line by line for better understanding. Friends, here, John Masefield's Laugh and Be Merry, no doubt it is one of the most popular, most acknowledged and cheerful poems, and it talks about how one can live cheerful and happy life. Friends, here the poet expects from us that we should try to extend the cheerfulness and happiness to our near and dear ones, towards the society, and we should always try to boost them to live their lives positively and happily. Friends, here this poem talks and appeals to the readers like you and me to laugh and be merry, because our span on this earth is very short and we all should always be proud and glad to be part of this world which is created by the God or the Almighty. In fact, friends, as we all know, today the entire world, the entire globe has been facing a critical phase of COVID-19 pandemic, and we all are passing through the toughest phase of our lives. And we strongly believe in the quote of P.B. Shelley that if winter comes, can spring be far behind. So very soon everything will be normal, and we pray for this to the Almighty. So here, friends, we need to be stable, positive and energetic to push back these critical moments so that we may enjoy the upcoming moments with the same zeal and same enthusiasm that we had earlier. Friends, this poem is also very much optimistic and positive in tone, and incredibly straightforward and hopeful in its subject as well. Friends, here John Masefield nicely depicted the positive portrait of being happy for human being or every individual. He also made ample use of the figures of speech, and we come across the application of, you know, metaphor, then hyperbole, personification, alteration and so on while dealing or while exploring this piece of composition. So friends, here we must know something about John Masefield, and John Masefield's full name is John Edward Masefield. Friends, he was an English poet and born on 1st June 1878 and died on 12th May 1967. He is best known for his poems of the sea salt water poems and ballads published in 1902, and his long narrative poems like The Everlasting Mercy published in 1911 and Dover published in 1913. These poems talk about the struggle against ignorance and materialism. Friends, we are familiar with his other crucial contribution like Renard the Fox, published in 1919, which talks about the rural life of England. And we have Sard Harker, published in 1924. Then we have The Midnight Fog, published in 1927. Then The Box of Delights, published in 1935. And Basilisa, published in 1940. These are his novels. And The Tragedies of, you know, Nan, published in 1909. Then The Tragedy of Pompey the Great, published in 1910, are some of his well-known poetic dramas. Friends, here, he preserved his personal experiences and struggle in his autobiography called In the Mill, published in 1941. Friends, it is also notable he was awarded the Order of Merit in 1935, and he was the Poet Laureate of the United Kingdom from 1930 to 1967. So friends, this poem has 16 lines, and let us begin with the first four lines of the poem, or the first stanza of the poem. In the first four lines of the poem, John Masefield says, "Laugh and be merry, remember, better the world with a song, better the world with a blow in the teeth of a wrong. Laugh, for the time is brief, a thread the length of a span. Laugh and be proud to belong to the old proud pageant of man." Friends, in fact, the title of the poem itself shows the central theme of the poem. Laugh and be merry means keep always smiling and be happy forever. Friends, in these four lines, the poet says that the main principle of our life should be to laugh and be merry. Suffering, troubles, pain, and such things are part of life, and we have to face all these things with a smile on our face. Friends, in the first line itself, he says we need to smile always and be happy, and we should never give up this habit so that we can improve the world in which we are living, and it should be done with a beautiful song or a beautiful rhythm. Friends, mostly we sing a song in a jolly mood and not in a monotonous phase or boring phase, and that's why he might be saying it. Friends, later on he says that if something wrong is happening, or some antisocial things are taking place in the world or in the society, then you should be there to stop it and create happiness there. Friends, as we know very well that today's scenario and the consequences of the COVID-19 pandemic, so we should be there to remove the stress, botheration, pain, suffering and troubles, and create and spread happiness among the people in the society or people around us. Here, friends, he also says that the time span we got from the God is very brief, and it is just like the thread. Therefore, we should not waste it in such unproductive and unwanted or antisocial things which keep us away from laughing and enjoying the beauty of life and happiness. Friends, in the last line of the first stanza, he says that we must feel proud to be the part of this fraternity of human beings or humanity, and it has a very long hierarchy or series of development, and therefore he says that we are fortunate enough to have this opportunity. Therefore, friends, we should always try to be happy. Friends, in these four lines, there are some words or phrases like better the world, which means improve the world, in the teeth of wrong means right in the direct line of attack. Then we have pageant, that means series of events. Now, in the next stanza, the poet says, "Laugh and be merry, remember in olden time. God made heaven and earth for joy. He took in a rhyme, made them and filled them full with the strong red wine of his mirth. The splendid joy of the stars, the joy of the earth." Friends, in this stanza, in this second stanza, the poet says that again he appeals and requests the readers like you and me to laugh and be merry and never forget the old time of the God or Almighty who created heaven and earth for joy and not any other things or unwanted things or antisocial things. Here, friends, the God has created these places for the joy and happiness, and we should never forget it. We should always keep it in our mind. The God has made heaven and earth and filled them with the strong red wine of his mirth. Here, mirth means happiness or joy or amusement. Furthermore, friends, he says that God has created the stars in the sky, which symbolizes joy and happiness. Here he says, in short, the poet tries to express that, he tries to convince us that everything which has been created by God is only for us, and we should try to enjoy it. Friends, here also there are some words like myth, which means amusement or laughter, and we have one more word, splendid, that means grand. Now, friends, in the third stanza, John Maxfield says, so we must laugh and drink from the deep blue cup of the sky. Join the jubilant song of the great stars sweeping by. Laugh and battle and work and drink of the wine outpoured in the dear green earth, the sign of the joy of the Lord. So here, friends, in this stanza, the poet continues to convince us and says that we must laugh and drink from the deep blue cup of the sky. We must celebrate this gift of life given by God or Almighty, and therefore there is no limit of this joy, enjoyment or happiness. Friends, it is completely perpetual, like the blue sky. There is the jubilant song being sung by the great stars in the sky, and we should always try to enjoy it. He says that, friends, they are singing for us in the sky, and we should enjoy the same, we should try to enjoy it our level best. Furthermore, he says that laugh and, you know, battle, it means we have to laugh and fight against the bad things or the obstacles which may come in our ways of laughing and enjoying the beauty of life created by God. Friends, here we need to work sincerely and try our best to give justice to the responsibilities shouldered upon us and enjoy the happiness being poured by the Almighty, O God. And in the last line of this stanza, he says, the joy and happiness is the sign of the Lord created in this green earth, which means prosperous earth. Here, word green indicates prosperity. Friends, here also we have some words like jubilant, that means extremely pleased and ready to celebrate, and green earth means prosperous earth. Then, friends, in the last stanza, John Maxfield says, laugh and be merry together like brothers akin, guesting a while in the rooms of a beautiful inn, glad till the dancing stops and the lilt of the music ends. Laugh till the game is played and be you merry, my friend. Friends, in the last stanza, the poet says that laugh and be merry and live always together. We should try to live selfless lives, and bonding of togetherness should always be there. It should always be maintained nicely or properly. Our deeds and emotions should be sincere, and it should be there for lifetime. It should not be for time being. It should not be there for time being only, and it should be there for lifetime. We are here on the earth for a very short span, very short period, and one day we are going to leave this world, we are going to leave this earth. Therefore, he calls the earth an inn in which we all people have been residing. We are the guests in the rooms of a beautiful inn created by God. Furthermore, he says that nobody knows when the dancing is going to stop. Here, dancing means life, which can be stopped anytime. He says nobody knows when exactly the rhythm of life stops or ends up, and therefore we should always try to be happy. Here, friends, this life is just like the game, and we must try to play it with great zeal, happiness and enthusiasm, and try to live our life before it ends up, and always try to be happy in all kinds of circumstances. Friends, here also we have some words like akin, which means related in some way. Guest while means to stay overnight. Lilt of the music means a pleasant pattern of rising and falling sound. So friends, it is all about John Maxfield's popular composition called Laugh and Be Merry. Friends, I hope you have liked this video and presentation. And if you have really liked it, friends, then I request you to like it, share it among your friends, near and dear ones as well. Friends, if you are a new viewer to this channel, and if you have not subscribed this channel yet, then I request you to subscribe the channel by just pressing the subscribe button and hitting the bell icon, so that you may get the notifications of uploaded such academic videos on this particular channel called English Carnival in coming days. So friends, very soon we'll meet again with the video of multiple choice questions based on this composition only, John Maxfield's popular composition Laugh and Be Merry. So friends, till then, I request you, just take care of yourself and be happy. Thank you very much, friends.